Buenos dias, sir, and good evening. MannwidaPlann here. Welcome back, everybody, to some more Subnautica. And look at this guy. Look at this guy. He keeps doing it. He keeps wandering away. And he does his funky little flashy thing. And he goes wherever he goes and does whatever he does. There he is. And then a little while later, he comes back and just wails. Like, wails on my submarine. It's at 50% health now already. But every time I try and move it somewhere, he just follows us. So I have my welder with me anyway, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, there's not much power on it, but I have it. So, yeah, in the last episode, we went exploring around and getting lost in the little caves around on this island. And then as I worked my way out, this really big, humongous cave right next to where we first parked actually leads exactly where we ended up. So we could just run in this way. It would have saved a lot of time and effort. But I'm a little bit more prepared for this exploration this time. Well, equipment-wise prepared. Mentally, I really am not. This is absolutely terrifying doing this. But I have lots and lots of O2 tanks. I've got my rebreather equipped as well. Not as much food and water as I would like, but we'll kind of make do with what we can do about that, I guess. So, let us see where this goes and what that terrifying noise was. Because it was freaky as sin. It scared the living poop out of me. So I'm going to go ahead and just swim our way down normally until we get to about the spot where we were last time, where we started losing our O2 a lot faster. And hopefully we will be able to get to the bottom of this. Quite literally. And then it was this way, I think. Man, it's so super spooky here, so super spooky. Yep, then it was down this rather intimidating deep black hole. Straight down. Yeah, here come the biters again. Yeah, we're just going to completely ignore them. I think I picked up some more health packs on my way out. Some cool new flora there that we're going to scan. We're not going to. We'll just swim over here. Yeah, this is where the oxygen bubble was, and this is where we came back to in the last one, because we headed down a little bit and heard an absolutely terrifying noise, and we didn't have our rebreather, and we were losing our oxygen too fast. Let's kill some biters while we regen some O2. Where are you, you little... Yeah! Oh, just got away from me. Just got away from me. You're lucky. Where's your friends? Yeah! Yeah! Okay, that's us full. Let's do this. So, we just want to be going down. Down into the terrifying dark depths. That's it. Long round this way. Super, super, super long cave. And, oh! Ah, it just seems to lead outside. I was wondering if that was a thing, because as I left the island after finishing the recording, I saw a Reaper Leviathan, like, floating underneath the bottom of me, and I thought, do you think I just heard him? Do you think maybe I just heard the Reaper Leviathan and thought there was something terrifying in this cave? But again, if that's all that there is, and it's just another way in here, then maybe we're missing something actually on the island. Or maybe they just haven't implemented it yet. Maybe that's the other thing, is they're still working on it. It's possible. It is possible. So I know this game is still a work in progress, and I know they're doing everything they can to kind of create things for it. I think this is the way that we just came. End up getting lost in the cave. Yep, that's the direction that we just came from. Ah. Hmm. How super strange. Perhaps we are missing something else then. If this just seems to lead back outside, maybe there is, after all, another way for us to go. He says as he just gets completely lost in the cave and runs out of O2. That doesn't go anywhere. Laggy, laggy, lag. Seems to go up. Up is good as I watch my O2 start to get smaller and smaller and smaller. Up is always good. Okay, oh, is this where the oxygen bubble is? It is! Well, I mean, don't get me wrong, it's a beautiful cave. It's really awesome down there. But alas, it seems as though there's not actually anything of too much interest in here at the moment. Oh, struggled to get out of the water then. How very strange. Hop up. Unless it is that I am missing something actually inside this cave network on the island. Well, I'm totally clueless. If you guys know anything else about this island, please do drop some notes in the comments for me, as I'm a little clueless myself. But I'm not going to spend more than 2.5 episodes exploring it. I think that's kind of enough time. But we've got other things that we've got built, or rather got collected, so that we can make what we're looking for. So we'll go ahead and call this one explored for now. Hop back to our submarine, hope it's not destroyed. 10% health, look, good lord. That thing's just been wailing on it. Little gets, man, little gets. Let's just weld this guy up a little bit for the journey home. And yeah, I'll head back on home and we'll check out what we need to get our thermal generator up online and running. In fact, I might spend a bit more time here and gather up some more gold. Whoa, what happened? Whoa, what was that? What on earth was that? That scared the freaking producers out of me. Oh. Whew. So I guess that's their kind of trick. He just pulled me straight over to him so he could give me a bite. Okay, don't like those either. That scared the freaking poop out of me. So yeah, I'm going to gather up some more gold first and then I'll head home. After I relax my butthole a bit. Whew. Ah, home. Ah. It's always so good to return after a long adventure. And what an adventure it was. Oh look, we have a message. We'll check that out in just a moment. I believe I've already put all of my equipments back away. Yeah, we've got down to the 302 tanks, which should be plenty. And just really our standard set of kit. Our battery levels are super, super low. We got a spare there in case. A little bit of cured food left. Running drastically low on water yet again. What is this? I have no idea. We've been getting quite a few of those little garbled transmissions. I've not seen them before any other time I've been playing. It must be something with a new update, but I still don't quite understand it at all. Very, very strange. Oh look, we have a trespasser. Another trespasser. So, we have returned, we are back, and the first thing I am wanting to do... Let's see here, I bet I'm not carrying my building tool. Nope, of course not. Let's go and grab that. Let's see what we need for this thermal plant. I know we needed the magnetite, and we have lots of that stuff now. Let's have a gander. So, on here, one of these, and we also are able to work on our cyclops, that's the word. Oh, we have that too. In the moon pool, we gotta get the moon pool up. Oh, so much to do. So, a titanium ingot, magnetite, and lubricant. I believe I have a couple of lubricant, actually, from when I disassembled the... Oh, look at all the trespassers, get out of my house! From when I disassembled, it would be here, in fabricated. Yeah, they were from the, what was it called? The bioreactors. Okay, excellent. So, titanium ingot. Just the one, yeah? Indeed, indeed. That is made with a buttload of titanium, if memory serves. 10 of them. Okay, right. I'm gonna go and gather up some titanium, then. Okay. Good thing there's that little wreck just outside of our home. That makes it a lot easier for us to gather this stuff up. Two of these. As I am planning on making two, yes, two, of our thermal plants. I don't want any more power issues anymore. I've had enough of them. Hopefully, two of these will be enough to sustain our needs on their own. From what I can tell, I believe that a thermal plant is the most regular, consistent form of power. So, four magnetite and two lubricant, which we have. I believe I've kept it all in here. Lithium, diamond, magnetite. One, two. Four of those. And in the fabricated, we have our two lubricant. Amazing. Now, our little thermal vent is quite a way away. So I believe these things will come in handy. Gold and titanium. I'll need more titanium. I know I have buttloads of gold. That was a mix of buttloads and plenty of. So if I grab all of that, Actually, let's go get some more titanium first. And then I'll grab all of that, because the titanium is huge. And if I put all of these bits away, actually, as well, it'll just save up some inventory space. Yeah, that's enough. That'll be fine. Okay, so, a little bit more titanium arms. I may as well bring you guys along for this bit. We'll have a little bit of a chance to have a chat, a little catch-up. See how everything's going on in the world. There's a huge square there that hasn't rendered in, and the game is lagging like sin because of it. So, bear with us here. This is the only bit I don't like about living in this area, is the freaking sand sharks, man. The sand sharks are so real, they're really annoying. They just refuse to leave me alone. They can't hurt my boat. Thankfully, they can't hurt my little sub. But they don't stop trying. They really do not stop trying. They always love to try and chomp through it, and it just doesn't work. There's a couple of pieces there. That's all really all about all we need. I just put myself about here. Oh, the lag is so bad at the minute. Good lord. So, one of them. One of them. Hop back in before I get chewed. Oh, dear god. This is what happens when, like, one square just refuses to render in. And the game just suffers drastically because of it. If I can find one more piece would be amazing. Also, this little hole is still here, which we haven't investigated yet. There's some cool little jelly things in there. Like some little hanging jellyfish things that I'd like to check out. What's over in this kind of direction? I am also seriously on the hunt for the other fragment for the battery cell charger. As we have the little battery charger, but we don't have the battery cell charger. And I'm pretty sure that I had found that in a grasslands biome. I'm not entirely certain. I know we found it somewhere along our travels at one point, but I can't really recall. But I do have a very strong feeling that it was in a... oh, sorry, little hoopfish. In one of these biomes, but no luck as of actually spotting one around as of yet. Any more titanium, please? Just one more piece of scrap metal would be very, very, very well substantial. It'd be all I'd really be looking for. Yes, yes, I know. Stop trying to eat my ship. It doesn't work. You're just going to give yourself a headache. A little bit of scrap there. No, no scrap there. Ow. This is back to the bit of scrap that's next to us. Hmm. Oh, well, never mind. There's a very good chance that the 8 pieces that we have will suffice. So let's just go back. Oh, my lord, the lag. I can't wait to get out of this area and hope it renders back in. So let's go and cook up these into some usable titanium. Hop. And hopefully this will be enough to build the thermal plants and use the power transmitters to get the power over here. And then we can get our water filtration system back online and I won't have to chase any more bladderfish. Because I am very, very, very low on water. Very, very low on water. And I don't want to chase any more bladderfish. I really, really don't. Wrong box. This one. So, I'm going to take this and this. And 1, 2, 3, 4 of them. And all the gold that I can carry. I think I only needed 8. Does look to be about right. Was it 1 titanium and 1 gold for this? Sure was. Okay, that's it. We're ready. Awesome. Excellent. To spare you guys the lags, I am just going to cut... Wow, I parked really close. oh, good lord, stop trying to... Oh, no, that was my fault. I thought it was a I thought it was a sand shark then, but it wasn't. It was just me bumping into it. I believe it was the northwest is where this thermal vent is, if memory serves. Let's get out of that area. There it is. Big old hole in the ground right here. Boom. Now, I'm not entirely sure how these things work, but I believe it would be a case of as close as you can get, the better power you get. It would make sense to me, I assume. So let's go and see what these things look like anyway. Oh, are you going to give me a snap? Whoa, oh! Okay, it hurts to get near it. Have I got to time it? Ha 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 ha! There we are. It doesn't hurt that much. I get a little bit of a red flash going on, but I'm very, very, very slowly losing health. So let's try and get this one in a good spot too. About there, looks good. Ow. Okay, why couldn't I build that one? Let's get away from the heat. There we are. Titanium ingot. Magnetite. I'm sure I picked up both of those. Apparently I did not. Okay, well let's run back home. No, it wasn't that box. I'm sure it was this one. I'm absolutely sure that I made two titanium ingots. I am absolutely certain of it. Where did I put it? What? Didn't put it in fabricated. I didn't put it in there either. There's just a buttload of peeper in there. I'm absolutely sure I made two of them. How strange. Okay, well, we'll make another one. I'm certain I made two of these things. Absolutely sure of it. I don't know what happened there. I probably lost it, like a fool. And two more of the magnetite. I'm sure I grabbed four. Mild dehydration detected. Uh-oh. Ah, I see why. Look, I've picked up lithium. That's not going to help. Two more of those. Okay, water is an issue again, so I'm going to have to run around and grab a little bit more water. I'll do that while we're over at the thermal vent, and then I'll bring you guys back. Ah, okay. I'm all hydrated and feeling much better now. And I believe I may have been an idiot, and I'm pretty sure the reason why I didn't have a titanium ingot is that it had taken the titanium ingot already when I started building this one. So let's go and burn our butthole a little bit more trying to build this one up. Probably could have done with putting them a little closer to this edge, actually. Let's try that. If I take this one apart... Yeah, we gave me back the titanium ingot. I thought it might have. Because we are wanting to head towards the Seamoth and our little new spot beacon part there. So let's see if I go to build one. Yeah, that would be a better place. There we are. Because that one's a little bit further away. Because we want the power to go that way. So let's deconstruct that one. Put it next to the other one over there. Oh, it's warm. Oh, I'm burning my butt. Thankfully, you don't burn yourself really fast, but I'm guessing that the closer you get, the worse it gets. So let's go ahead and try and put this one around about here. Okay, maybe not at such a steep angle. That does look a little bit silly. Okay, steep angle it is then. Okay, so long as you work, I don't mind. Awesome. So we have some thermal plant generators. Let's get out of the heat. There we are. I brought some extra health packs just for this reason. As I figured it would be a thing. Awesome. Okay, we'll take this piece of scrap. Why wouldn't we? Thank you. And now let's see what happens when we try and hook one of these up. Oh, I got blue lights. Can I stick you to the ground, please? That looks perfect. Ding ding. Ha 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 ha. Now we want to head towards our little new spot marker. So, let's see if we can connect that one with this one here. Sure looks like we can. I'm sure I could probably get better range on this, but I'm just more worried about it actually like being interrupted if I do get like long stretches of passing through the ground or something like that. I'm not sure. Let's see. And we want to make it look beautiful, of course. Of course we do. We have to make it look nice. If you're going to build, build it look nice. Emergency. 10 seconds. If you're going to build, suffocate while you're doing it. There we go. And again, because getting oxygen drains the power of that, I'm just going to get some fresh O2. Ah, fresh air. Ah. Ah, how refreshing. Alrighty, let's move the sea moth a little bit closer to where we're going for home. No, not beacon label. There we are. I wonder how much of a range we can get on these things. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, I was very wrong. We can get loads of range on these. Which is good, because using gold, they're fairly expensive. Let's go for... yeah, about there. Titanium, right? Yeah, I'm gonna guess so. Let's have a quick glance. Oh yeah, it's titanium. Easily fixed. Easily fixed. Hopefully I'm gonna have enough gold to get it all the way down here as well. Could be a thing. I might have some more gold. Might just have some more gold.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Why, thank you, Base. So nice to be home. Soon you'll have all the power that you could ever need. Do I have more gold? I do have more gold. Oh yeah, give me all that sweet lag, sweet gold action. There we are. I've got enough titanium on me for another 8, because I foolishly made an extra ingot that I didn't actually require. There we are. I don't think I've got any more titanium lying around. I think... I got one. Why not? Can't get past the plant pot. I had a feeling that when I built that there, it was going to get in the way. Let's just do this. No, it'll take too long to swim over there and there's sand sharks everywhere. Frickin' sand sharks. Oh yeah, and biters, don't forget them. So about this direction, yeah, it is a bit of a stretch. Although we're already on this little cliff edge here, so it shouldn't be too bad. Okay. There's that one. Now let's go for a big long stretch down to, say, this mark here. It looks good. You got range? It's hard to see. Yeah, I think you have. Yeah, you do. Ding! Haha, I love the power beams. It's awesome. Why is it shooting through the floor like that, though? Oh, wait, is it already connecting to the base? Holy moly, is that already connecting? I mean, if it is, it's safe as a buttload of gold. It looks a bit silly dropping through the floor like that, but I'm guessing... yeah, it is. It's shooting straight through the cliffside and into that foundation to give us power. Oh, man. Oh, yeah. Does that mean... I believe it means that we should no longer have any power issues. I really hope so, but I doubt it. 200 out of 200. Okay, let's test it. The big moment. The big moment. This thing only takes titanium, and I have enough. Let's have a look. I wanted to make it in here, if memory serves. Get out of my house, fish. Let's see how well this holds up now. Two of these. Let's see here, 198. 196, 197, 194, oh, 195, 193. It is still dropping, isn't it? It is still dropping. Nowhere near as fast as it did the last couple of times. Just maybe, if I was to make another thermal plant, or really I could just fill that vent with thermal plants, I guess, couldn't I? And that might just take care of it all. We could give it a try. We have another titanium ingot on us. We have the magnetite to be able to do it. The only thing that we would need would be the lubricant. If I'm right. Which I believe I am. Yeah, it would just be the lubricant. Why not? I'm going to put a third one up. Why wouldn't I? I already made a titanium ingot. But yeah, that power is still dropping. And the sad part is with it being daytime, actually we could test it. With it being daytime, we will be getting power out of these solar panels. But if I take these away to simulate what it would be like at night time, I bet our base would power down. But just maybe if we could get it enough power to be stable on the thermal plant alone. Go away, Bider. Then just maybe we might actually be able to make a sustainable power source out of this power event. These water filtration systems are incredibly handy, but man, such a power cost. So expensive in electric. Unbelievable. So let's grab some more of these. I don't know if I can carry four. Nope, two, but that's okay. Two's all we need. Where is it? There it is. Head on down. I'll make this one up and we'll go and place a third. Yeah, look, 99 already. It's almost holding at that power level. Almost. So I think if we put a third one, it should actually make it sustainable. I need three, don't I? Ah, nuts. And double nuts. Our little Seamoth has ran out of power and I have no more power cells left. So we're just going to do this one on the little T-Glide. I do have a battery left for this, so that's totally fine. But we have all the parts. Let's build another one of these and see if we can stabilize our power issues on these things alone. I'm hoping that this one will have range to connect to these without me having to place more of these things down. Let's see, let's just try and put it... Oh yeah, about there. That should connect easy, right? Are you going to connect? It might be that I'll have to remove this. And then just build it again. Okay, I have another one now. Don't care, so long as the power gets where it's needing to go, I will not mind. Ding, 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 ding. Alright, power restored and all primary systems online. Let's see if it's stabilized. I hope it is, because that's all the magnetite I had, so I can't build another one for a while. Oh, poor little Seamoth, you just chill out there, it's fine, I'll get you some power in a minute and do. So, we got... sitting at 150 our max power now as well. But... that looks like it's holding. If anything, it's actually going up. I think we've done it, people. I think we've managed to suss it out. Absolutely excellent. Yeah, this will be a real step in the right direction. I'll investigate a little bit more just to make sure that it is actually holding. I'm curious why that's gone down to 150. I could have been... Oh, no, it would have been. I removed the two little... what's it called? Solar panels, that's the word. it's early in the morning for me now. But yeah, I think that's worked quite well. Fantastic. Well, again, thank you guys very much for coming to join me today. I'm really, really pleased. It looks like we've got our power issue stabilized, which means we will have filtered water galore. We have Reginalds in here now. It should be, yeah, they're breeding away, so we'll have loads of them for food as well. So that should be us in a self-sustainable state. Are you creating? Oh, yeah, you are creating. Yeah, and our power is not draining, and we don't even have solar. Looks like we are independent. Amazing. Again, thank you guys so much for coming to join me. If you are enjoying the Subnautica, please hit that like and drop some subscribes for me. It really, really will help out the channel. It's still very early days for me in the YouTube gaming channel, but I really appreciate all the support I can get. Do make sure you drop back soon and check out the new episodes when they arrive. I hope you've had a fantastic evening and a great day prior, and I shall see you all again soon. I'm a little thirsty again. I have some fruit while I'm waiting.